Blackstone Audio presents Fantastic Imaginings, a journey through 3,500 years of imaginative writing, comprising fantasy, horror, and science fiction. Compiled, edited, and introduced by Stefan Rudnicki. Read and otherwise performed by David Burney, Scott Brick, Cassandra Campbell, Danny Campbell, Christopher Kazanov, Gabrielle DeCure, Colin Davies, Harlan Ellison, Lewis Hauser, Artie Johnson, Blas Kisich, Rosalind Landor, John Lee, Don Leslie, N. Rytel, John Rubenstein, Stefan Rudnicki, Tom Schiff, Bonnie Turpin, Myron Willis, Michael York, and Judy Young. Introduction by Harlan Ellison.
Lofty Ambitions by Harlan Ellison. Reading by Harlan Ellison. This is a soigné chrestomathy. For those who speak even less idiomatic French than I, permit me to translate. Soigné is one of those words that mean more than its translation explicates. As with Latin and Yiddish and a few other deep and rich languages, it contains in its linguistic parameters an infinitude of shadings and interpretations. Ignorantia leges neminem excusat and l'esprit d'escalier are two perfect examples. Soigné is best translated as meaning carefully or elegantly done or designed, well-groomed. Think Cary Grant, if you will. Chrestomathy is merely a highfalutin synonym for compendium, collection, anthology, anna, agglomeration, aggregate, mass, pile, mishmash, heap, bunch of tchotchkes. But why such pompous, fastidious words? Well, when I am thrust into the company of the great, or the near great, not just the faddish or controversial or infamous, the tabloid platypus of the week, but the genuinely awe-inspiring, I am beset by an idiotic reaction formation that thereafter makes me want to hide myself from sight by screwing myself into the ground and descending to a subterranean place where consummate darkness will shroud me from the ridicule of my betters and casual onlookers. What happens is this. I feel the bumpkin just fell off the turnip truck. Spots on my tie, shoes unshined, baggy in the seat of my pants, a clod, a yokel, a cadote from the sticks. I farted in mixed company. My tongue, sadly, does not get tangled over my eye teeth so I cannot see what I am saying. It just begins to flop, to blabber and gibber and go on in an obstinately endless farrago of dumbass remarks, and all of them in velvet verbiage, purple into the ultraviolet, words whose meanings I've forgotten or never knew, sentences so prolix that little girls in Harlem could use them for their double Dutch exercises. Imprecisions and redundancies that make hip-hop and rap lyrics seem like the most golden moments of Langston Hughes. In short, my friends, I demonstrate a feeling of inferiority and stunned idolatry that clearly screams, Mayday! Mayday! As with one of the dippy characters played by Mike Myers and Dana Carvey in the Wayne's World skits, on very rare occasions a clarity of perception comes to me when I am out of my depth, playing in a game too rich for my blood, way in over my head, and I fall to my knees, wrench at my forelock, and genuflect as I cry, I'm unworthy! Unworthy, I say, unworthy! I have been brought to this place, to the end of this noble and worthy race that has been run by my betters, to bid you a kind of welcome. And I stand wholly unadorned and ignoble, sweating like a barnyard animal, abruptly confronted with the realization that my credentials aren't worth a buttonhook when it comes to commenting on this collection. At least to comment properly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.